Hello, my friends. I am going to make a Christmas craft, and it's a Christmas journal. Now, I will let you know ahead of time that this video is not going to air until or upload until later, and I will have been using this Christmas journal throughout December. I bought a few supplies that I've never used before for this journal. I went ahead and bought a whole bunch of different kinds of glue from Amazon. Glue stick. Well, there's all different kinds here, and I'm really not sure which I'm going to use or how I'm going to use it yet, so bear with me as I discover. In fact, all of these supplies can be found on Amazon, and I will do my best to put the links to all of these different items in my descriptions underneath the video if you're interested in purchasing some of these. This is a big wad of kind of antique, old-fashioned, not antique, I should say, vintage-looking stickers for Christmas. I'll show you in just a sec. Alright. This package. I don't think that sticker is outside. I think I need to open it first. Anyway, my Christmas journal is very unusual, so I will explain about that in a minute. Hang with me. Just take a look at these marvelous supplies that I bought. They all have different sayings here. Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Joy, Merry and Bright, Let It Snow. I love those. I just love them. They're even better than they looked on Amazon. Okay, so what else do I have in my magic Amazon bag? I just love Crinkles. Amazon bags are so magical. Okay, this also I got from Amazon, and in kind of thinking ahead about my project here, I decided that these kinds of stickers in particular would go with my project, and you'll see why in just a little bit. Aren't they neat? I'll take them out. They are far more faux antique or aged pieces of paper. Various sizes to make it look also like there are burnt edges to be moody. And these are more stationery-like, I guess, to give the impression of organization and writing, which is what I want to do in my Christmas journal. I didn't care too much for the white edges, but we'll see how it goes with my project. Okay, that's that. this other package of paper that has, it's Kraft paper that has adhesive on the back. I went ahead and pre-cut from this Town Sticks brand Kraft paper from Amazon. I carefully went through the whole entire magazine, and actually I had a little helper, and that Avery and I sat down and cut all of these papers with an old-fashioned paper cutter with the arm that comes down, numbered them per page. She wrote most of the numbers. Yeah, so that was done ahead of time to save time on this video, because this is going to be a long project. Hopefully long enough to just put you all to sleep for half the night. But I just need to take a second. Listen to this. Oh, my. I wonder why I'm so crazy about paper crinkles. But that's what this magazine represents. Because last year I put a little water damage on it, and I have just been enjoying the heck out of it all year long, just listening to it and playing with pages and looking at it over and over again. But what I want to do is take these stickers and put them on and over these words. Each page kind of has an area, like so, this shape that will need to be covered in order for me to write in them and to alter the style of the magazine. So if I'm to remove all words, I need to take papers to cover them. And this big giant advertisement on the front page is not nice looking, so I am going to take a full page in this circumstance and cover it. This looks like a nice glue. Just gonna see how this turns out. Since it's a thicker front cover, it should be okay with those, with that glue being a little more chunky. Okay, so I have covered my first page with a nice piece of stationery. A winter scene. The lake and the cardinal. This is a beautiful saying, so I'm not going to cover it, I don't think. But I will need to go ahead and cover some of the words on the front. And you see the words Happy Holidays on the front here is the same color as my Kraft paper. Although not everything is going to match. Get rid of the white lettering. And it's like I'm saying Happy Holidays to myself. Okay, I numbered my little Kraft papers. And I don't know how some of this got out of order, but I just go according to how I numbered things. This is page 4. I get rid of the word style. Just Christmas. Alright, so I want to get rid of the word style up there too. So let's sign on a few my work. I also intend to cover the UPC symbol, and I'm going to put a Kraft paper binding on the outer edge, which you will get to see in the final result at the end of the video. So if you wanted to skip forward really fast to see the end result, that's fine. But you gotta watch the process again some other time. I think that would look good right on the edge there. Now I am just flying by the seat of my pants. The only thing I planned here for sure were to cover certain words and letters. That's all I prepared for. The rest of it I'm gonna be just thinking as I go. These stickers are not easy to get apart. I had to practice a few times, but you'll see. You just watch, I just know I'll get better and faster at it, but meanwhile there's probably going to be a lot of splice as I struggle over this Kraft paper and these stickers. Nice, that one was easy. So I'm trying to, sizes. Uh-oh. Look at that. I've already gone crooked. Just got to trim a little off of here. I'll neaten things up later. Okay, so I can't just leave it like that. I have to add more dimension to this, so we think well, I like the white edges on this because it'll blend in with the other white edges in the middle. So there now. I have a place to write in my Christmas journal magazine. As I go along, you'll see how I've salvaged, or how this Christmas magazine will turn into a Christmas journal. I can see it in my mind's eye, but as we go, I'm going to be in as much a question as you as to how this is going to turn out. So since those pages had only words, I just decided to come together and make one page out of it. Need something. It's a circle, so maybe I can put a circle on a circle. I think I'm gonna get something square because the circle didn't cover all the letters. I'll just put this one upside down. It seems like paper clips should go the other way, but I don't care. For my purposes, I need them to go upside down. Here, that covers the letters. Now, see this page has two printed areas, and the numbers coincide. See, it says 10, so I know it goes in the upper right-hand corner. This stuff is so sticky. It's crazy. It's the best. It's the best stuff. And I figured the Kraft paper kind of gives it a bit more of a warm and vintagey look. Duh, look what I did. Oh my gosh. Now I'm gonna have to cover that up a little bit. See if I can find something that'll cover up these other letters, because I don't have a Kraft paper piece for it. What a perfect fit. Yeah, see that, the Kraft paper having no, lined edges like this, I think I'm gonna add something else to it. Let's bring it and tie it together with another sticker. So, here, you know, my journal would be going through all these beautiful Christmas pictures, and I'll be sort of delighted, you know, every time I open up my journal. But I will also be able to write in all these various little places. Yeah, I'm not crazy about that. I wonder if there's something else I can do. I think that'll tie it in a little better. So looking forward to writing in this too, because I really have quite a few pages. And it's not going to be like, oh, the kind of journal where you write your deepest, darkest thoughts. Or that spots like that will be just for different little ideas that come to my mind, or as a matter of fact, I'm leaving the word inspiration up there, because that's sort of what this journal will be about. I will write and share thoughts about Christmas as I go along throughout the month. It'll be after I fill it in, it'll be something that I can actually share, rather like an album, if you know what I mean. I like that look. Some aspects of it will be incomplete in a way, but you know, there's no Kraft paper for that. I think I'm gonna pick out a sticker. That fits, but let me look around, see if I can find another one that has a better fit. So much to choose from here. I'm afraid, though, that I don't have a bunch of the larger sizes, so which looks better? That one, that looks kind of matchy, but I'm drawn to the size of this one. Or is it just, you know, adding some depth to this? I'm not too terribly worried about covering up parts of the pictures as long as you can get the main idea of what is in each picture. So, now I thought it was really interesting the way that they made these big framed sayings here. And I thought, oh, that's another one of those perfect opportunities for something to write in, like a journal. I don't know why I didn't cut this paper the right size, so let's get this a whack. I don't very good at cutting straight. I introduced my granddaughter to the cutting board that has the arm on it. You know, the old-fashioned cutting boards that you could use, teachers used to use to cut papers with precision. So it's got this big, heavy arm that drops down. It could drop down. You're not supposed to let it drop down. That's what I was afraid of while she and I were working together. And I'd put the paper in, and I'd say, okay, now you can pull the arm down. And I was like, not yet. Wait, my hands are out of the way. Just like, do I trust this child not to chop my fingers off? It's funny, because my husband was watching the whole thing, and he's going, Rebecca, do you trust her? She's only 7 years old. She doesn't have a concept of how actually sharp this thing is. And the arm that comes down is very heavy, purposely heavy. But all is well. I still have my fingers. Let's see if this sticker's still any good under this tape. It survived. I'm gonna use it. Alright, so now I have all that space to write on. And I like it. Christmas at Little Latches. Now see, this magazine is absolutely gorgeous the way it is. And I would save it just to look at again and again. But I like the idea of transforming it into a different Christmas experience. And since I'm loath to let go of it, let's make it useful. Okay, that kind of draw the eye away from the sharp edges. Looks like I needed another sticker down here. Doesn't have to be too big. I hope you can see clearly the subject matter in each photograph in this magazine. If you can't, I will go through this magazine at the end and show you the mostly finished product. And you'll be able to give me an evaluation. Okay, apparently I expected to have stickers in these spots. hate to cover up that gorgeous red. Maybe I should find a smaller. Look at that. Oh my gosh. That would cover the letters perfectly and still leave a burgundy lining. Watch this. Transformation. Well, it's a little crooked, but I just love that. What are we going to do about it? Alright, find another one for this area. I don't know how much of it I want to cover or if I want to leave any white in there. It's gotta be something that'll cover just the right amount. I wish I had bought more of these stickers. This might work. I think this is it. Cover up here. Do it this way. Be careful, Rebecca. Be careful. Now this is so difficult to line up. Oh gosh, look at that. That is not right. I wonder if this will come off. Ripping the page, so let's just tell you what. Now I have to do something to fix that. What can I do? I'll come back to it later. I'm like the kind of person who goes around straightening up crooked paintings on walls and that kind of thing, so trust me when I say it bothers me that I put that sticker on so crooked. But in order to share this experience with you, I have to keep my big fat head out of the picture. We're getting a train, can you hear it? Okay. I'm putting this brown craft paper on a page that has a white stove, but I think it'll still be okay. Do it from this side. Nah, it's too chancy, I think. It looks lined up, but I don't trust it. It's just... Come on, you can do it straight back. Do it straight. Come on, come on. I think I need a little something more on the edge. It looks too severe. Let's find a little smaller piece to add. Something needs to reduce the severity of this look. Edges on this sticker. That'll help. tie it in together a bit. I mean, it's really nonsensical in regards to the idea of writing on a page that has a wood-burning stove. If they could put writing there, then I can put writing there. My own writing. They pick strategic places to put lettering, even though it be less obtrusive than these brown stickers. It's still an opportunity. Voila. Okay. I like that. Now, just a little something in the middle. I think this will help tie it in. This is an interesting page. I've got the number corresponding with the paper, so I'm confident that that goes there. Let's get this thing off. Interesting that the color of their background for the lettering is not too different than my craft paper. And they did that even in spite of the fact that the building is white. Okay, I have to be so careful here. Everything is so sticky too, so it's like once it's stuck, it's too late. On that thing is like flypaper. And I don't know if any of you know what flypaper is, but it is, you know, the worst. You can't even, it's like super glue except sticky, you know, gooey. Okay, the white will kind of help bring But anyway, the stickers that I bought are not quite as sticky as I'd like them to be. It works well enough, but the only fortunate thing about it is that I can remove it and put it back on again if it's crooked. Alright. See, what's interesting is the grid form and schematics of this magazine, which is what got me so enamored with it in the first place, but also gave me the idea to turn it into a journal because it seemed easily transformable. It was already there. The schematics were such that it was a friendly project to alter. Let's see, I know I need to change. I mean, I could just leave it just like that, but I covered up edges, so That's, you know, that's just an instinct. I can't even tell you why I'm doing it this way. It just seemed too bold to leave all by itself. And that just added something for me. And I'll leave the right on or across both of those stickers. Beautiful tree. These places are just amazingly beautiful, and the magazine being about Christmas in different places of the world was intriguing to me in the first place, but it's also a beautiful background for writing. There I go again. Look at that. Jay is back. No choice. I've got to add something. I might have anyway, but what should it be though? Let's see what this would look like. Alright, that draws the eye away from that big glaring mistake. Here we go. Here's a nice big area. And write on page 31. This is a nice, long, sleepy project. And I wanted to film different perspectives. So let's go ahead and switch cameras here. Alright. you are not going to be able to see as well what each page looks like, but I'll give you a look through towards the end. Okay, I need my craft paper. There's a lot of words on this page. Perspective so that you could see some of my kitchen decorations. I won't be doing a house tour this year, so but I wanted to share a little bit of how things look and I think I've got a blue jay or a woodpecker outside that is just sounding off. I don't know if you can hear them, but they sound very persistent and possibly upset. While I'm doing this, I'll tell you a funny story. My granddaughter Avery, she's always watching me do my nails. And I went to put on a nail polish color. And I said, oh boy, I sure wish I had a really nice red. And I brought out the color that I'm wearing right now, and I put it on a paper plate. Sometimes I'll do that. I'll do a dab of paint on a paper plate so I can see what I think it's gonna look like. Well, this particular color I'm wearing right now, on the paper plate, because it was a white background, it made it look pink to me. And Avery was just like, no, Grandma, that's red. I said, well, it just really looks pink to me. She goes, Grandma, I'm telling you that it's red. And I said, and I'm telling you that I think it's pink. Grandma, I know I'm right. Okay. I didn't take her advice. I used something else at first. She was so upset at me. She just knew she was right. And so... Okay, that looks good right there. I like that. I just gotta put on more crafts sticker on the corner. Let's see. So anyway, she was so excited when she got home from school and saw that ultimately I had taken her advice. And I said, well, Avery, you were right. Eyes lit up, and she just was, and then she got this little devilish look in her eyes, like, yeah, see, I knew. I go, yes, sometimes a 7-year-old can be and no more than an adult every once in a while. And so the thing that I hadn't realized was that I was putting a kind of clearish kind of glittery red nail polish on a white background. That looks good. So, what does white and red make? Pink. Duh. Pink. So, I was getting the wrong impression of that color. So when you're putting it on your nails, you're not going to get a pink color. You're going to get red. Alright, this page, I'm just gluing it, and I'm putting a whole cover, like I did at the beginning of the magazine. And I will put, see, this is paper, it's like imitation, well, faux scroll, but it's kind of pretty and it matches the colors. I think I missed something here. Let me see, what am I doing? Yeah, okay, so I have the scroll paper on one side. And I need to put this Kraft paper on the other side. It's a weird arrangement on this side of the page because there's like an L going on here. So I did it in two shades rather than trying to cut out the one. Well, you'll be able to see this in the, when I go through. Just remember the, to look across from the page that has a old looking scroll on it with the blue edges, and you'll see I had to surround one photo. And so now, because I've got a seam, I want to kind of detract from that with a sticker. Gotta pick out the one that I think is most compatible. And that's the other thing, is you're looking at this and you're going, okay, size, shape, color. It's not rocket science, but it does take a certain amount of instinct regarding color and spatial relationship. And combinations. And where I'm not perfect at it, I am slightly gifted at knowing instinctively what will bring it all, tie it all together. And I didn't always know that. I think some of you know that I had a country gift shop once upon a time that looked like an old general store. And when I first began it, I knew that I had bit of a gift for decorating that was formulating inside me. I did not know, I was raising children, so I didn't give a whole lot of thought. I had four children, so I didn't give a whole lot of thought to decorating. It was just like, okay, that looks good. Throw the couch there. The kids are gonna trample it anyway, and I'm not worried about things being so beautiful necessarily. But I knew I had a little bit of an eye for what looked good. So I thought, well, when we opened up the gift shop, I was inspired because I thought, well, I can make things look good. I just really feel like I can. So let's try. And practice, you know, practice was making those skills develop a little bit. My kids were getting older, and by the time I actually had this gift shop, this Nelson's Country Store is what it was called, I was quite challenged and didn't have all of my gifts honed in, so I did okay, but I didn't, there was still a lot lacking. Nevertheless, the store just, you know, it took off because of what gifting that I did have. And then one day I met a gal at my church group who said that she used to have a gift shop years ago, and I was in her home and it just looked gorgeous. Not my style of decor, but it didn't matter. I could just see that she was way, way more gifted and talented than I was. And so when she said that she would be willing to work for me at my store, I jumped on it. I was just like, oh my gosh, you're kidding me. And so when she started working at the store and I saw how she operated, how she transformed things, I watched and I picked her brain, and I just was just like, okay, so why did you do that way? And so I learned a little bit about color arrangements and combinations, and I learned a bit about spatial relationship, although I knew a couple of things already. I am no pro or expert, but between my natural instincts and kind of learning by watching others, I have honed in my skills a lot more. As you may appreciate by looking at the scene of my room, my kitchen here. Alright, let's just gonna lay down flat. I do need to add something to the middle of this here, though. What should be... And the more stickers I put on, whether they be over words or not, will just give me more room to write. Let's cover up those words, too. It's just a small little area, but I want to sure every one of these gets covered up. Yeah, that's a nice big area right there. And So I also went to the consignment store this year. Not me this year. I go to the consignment store all the time. Let's put it this way. This year I went to the consignment store at Christmas time. This December, I should say. And found some of the most beautiful Christmas decorations. And I keep acquiring new ones every year. It is pathetic. I have crate after crate after crate of Christmas decorations. And this year, Melissa over at Portland Consignment had more Christmas stuff and merchandise in her store than she's ever had before. So I was quite excited, and boy, I could just spend so much money on decorating, but I really have to be so careful. Yeah, that looks good. It's funny how no matter what the subject of money comes up in my vocabulary, because there are things as I go along and I think, oh yeah, I bought this for this video, I bought this other thing for this video, I bought this for decorating, and it seems like the money that I put in to the items I buy go toward decorating and my videos. It's sort of like an investment, if you will. Make a little money and invest it right back into the business. But the lucky thing is that a lot of the things that I buy are tax deductible, I think is the term. I keep trying to talk and think here about what I'm doing at the same time. I don't know, but I think I might put a sticker on the edge of that one, of this one piece that I just put on. There's more words on this page I gotta cover up too. Boy, this is a tough choice. I think that one probably work. I might have to do a combination. But that'll be a good start. This is so amazing. I have lived in this town for like 7 years, I believe it's 7 years since 2014 when I moved here. And I finished. Look at it. Kraft paper. Right there, that'll fit. Right there. Okay, so anyway, I have been living in this town for 7 years, and so, you know, Brianna and my daughter and granddaughter have moved here, and my daughter discovered a thrift shop in town I knew about it. I had just never, ever bothered to go there. You know, you have this great little thrift shop in town. And the prices are so reasonable. I was going, what? Our town has a good thrift shop? Consignment store, yes. Gift shops, yes. Thrift shop? No way. She goes, no, look what I found. And she shows me a couple things and I go, what? Are you kidding me? And I had had a neighbor who was telling me about it all the time. Oh, she says, I go there all the time. It's like, oh, I can't even imagine. See, I just need a little small piece for that side. But big enough to... Got a lot of room. What do I think about that? Well, stickers are removable, so let's just try it. Let's see. I'm gonna cover up more area than just the words, but it's okay because I need more area to write. That's okay. I think that's all right. Just put a little dimension in it. Okay, so I went to this thrift shop with my other daughter, Abigail. And Brianna didn't get to go with us that day. I was like a kid in a candy shop. Okay, honestly, I was like an adult in a candy shop. I love candy, but I loved how much Christmas they had and clothing and every kind of imaginable thing squished into this smaller type of building. There we go, just start it. Hold that still. There we go. There we go, that worked. Just smooth it down a little. Add a little something in the middle. Anyway, there was such an amazing amount of beautiful things. So I bought some stuff that I loved and I am keeping it together in a bag because I want to do a thrift shop haul and show you everything I got and make it a combination of cleaning too, because there were some heavy plastic items in there and I think it's just gonna be so fabulous. It'll be so fun. But they are things that I can use too, so I'm excited. Be on the lookout for the thrift shop haul. And I'm going to show y'all what I got from Cares. It's called Cares. I think Cares is an acronym because there's a dot after each letter. C-A-R-E-S. It must stand for something. But I thought it was a very appropriately named I think it's appropriate because I asked the woman at the front who waited on me what their purpose is, I guess I want to say. And she said that they donate toward and find people that are hurting and don't have enough money to get by, and they help them, and they also donate towards the city's general needs, and they're just an all-purpose, multi-purpose thrift shop. And their prices are just incredibly low, so there's lots of people there all the time. And there are also quite a bit of good donations, some of which were mine, because I did bring some things there. I like that. I really had to embellish this one part because that was a big lot of lettering that I didn't want up at the top there. Let's see, there's just a little spot on this other page. I'll try to be here. Okay, that's good. I like that. Lots of writing room now. I have a designated paper for this page. There we go. That's gonna fit just right here. Pre-planned. Sticky this stuff is. I don't have to worry a bit about those edges staying on. Whereas I think I might have to go back and there's a word for reestablishing. The regular stickers. Maybe put more glue on the edges or something. Don't you hate it when the words you want won't come to you? Solidify? No, that's not the word. Not reaffix. I want to go back over the journal and what is that word? What is that word? I'll come up with it later. Reconstruct. No. Well, it's the word for just making it better and stronger. And more reliable. So, if I find any loose edges, I'll go back and fix them. Glue them down. Refurbish? No, that is not the word. Oh my gosh, it's gonna bug me. Somebody's gonna help me now. Okay, we can see that I put papers on those two pages. I needed to cover up a lot of lettering. Now, let's move away from my word obsession to continue on my journal. Let's see. I really love these red pages that have the rectangular shape. Such a perfect opportunity for a nice big area to write on. It'll be nice to just give myself all that much more space to write on. Swan's being difficult. Okay. Yeah, see, I like that. Should I add anything else? I'm leaving the bigger word up on this. I'm just going to cover the bottom part of the lettering because I like what it says. So I'll just put some round vintage stickers on the end of each side. That'll do it. And I'll write something that ties in with the word. Okay. There's just a small spot over here that needs to be cover up. It's daisies. Find just the right size. That's a little big. Come on, I know I can find the right piece. Maybe I can do a combination of two small ones. Seems like I should have cut out a craft paper for this, but I didn't. I should have. That doesn't. Something extra, though. I'm just gonna cover up this lantern, the top of this lantern. That looks better. It was just such a big, bright white spot on the page. Now, let's put just a little extra edge over here because I left a big white spot. That's a little parcel. Alrighty then. I didn't cut myself a piece of paper for that, and I do not know why. Because this is such an odd shape. I'm definitely gonna have to put two pieces over here, two stickers, to make the appearance that I want, to make it stretch across. And I'm not going to cut more craft paper. That work? See, not that smaller one, that won't work as well. Let's use this on one side. Okay, let's do that on the left side there. And then let's see, what should I use? Oh, yeah, a sticker. Wait. Oh, too late now. There's some words showing behind that sticker. I should have done something else. Oh, well. Okay. That will work nicely, I think. With the white edges. Should blend in with the other white edges on this page. That fits pretty darn good. Okay. Classically taught. I don't relate to that, even though I understand it. So the word classically doesn't really fit in with my ideas regarding a Christmas journal, so. But I did appreciate the article and the idea. I'm going to make it my own thing. It'll be kind of like a bookish thing. Since there are books up on top of the piano. Oh, yeah, I think that's a piano I just covered up. I didn't get a piece to fit that, so I'm going to have to use these. Envelope. started saying envelope, because if you think about the English language, envelope does not even make sense. It's an E. Okay, now I'm just babbling about whatever. Envelope, envelope, tomato, tomato, potato, potato, whatever. Okay, I'm gonna do it this way again. I think it'd be safer. Gotta line that up at the bottom of the page. It's so sticky. Come, let go, let go. Oh, brother, how do I get this over? Maybe I can just kind of stick some of it while my fingers are still on it. Oh, this is tricky. Very tricky. Gotta get my fingers out of the way and turn the page. So I think I'm just gonna get started. Oh boy, I hope that turned out. Let's see. Well, there's a little wrinkle in it, but I think it's okay. Just put something in the middle here. I'm curious, how many people do this new thing called Elf on the Shelf. Was trying to decide whether I would do that with Avery this year. But she has never seen the video or the movie, and neither have I. So I don't know how that tradition got started. Other than that movie. So I was talking to Brianna about it. Do you want to do Elf on the Shelf with Avery? And she said that'd be fine. She's not worried about having to carry on the tradition next year or anything. So I've been thinking about it and thinking about it, and I think I've decided not to do it. And as I said earlier in this video, I am doing this in early December, but I'm not uploading until later. So, I may yet change my mind about the Elf on the Shelf. Let's line this up very carefully. There we go. I think that worked out pretty good. Get it in the crease there. I didn't go over the edge on the bottom, so that works. Such pretty pictures. I just love. I'm just trying to see how many more stickers I'm gonna need to know how many I can actually use. Yeah, just put the circle on. Because I have plenty of those. I mean, I've got this big fat roll. There are so many stickers here, I could just, like, have them for 5 years to come, or more. I wonder what it was originally for, you know, they sell so many. Maybe a school. Okay. Find another sticker, put on the edge of that. I just feel so mellow right now, putting this journal together is so relaxing. It's like, if any of you can recall when you were young, having a sticker album, or, oh gosh, what we used to be able to get was a picture book with outlines, and you had to find the corresponding sticker to fit in the outline. And that's what this reminds me of. I loved it. I loved it. When I was really young, our stickers were not self-adhesive. They had a kind of gluey surface like an envelope that you had to lick. You had to lick it to make the adhesive work. So we would lick the stickers on the back and then put them on the pages. I didn't mind that either. I thought it was just so much fun. I think I was in my 30s when I did a little bit of work for a boyfriend of mine. No, 30s? No, I was still in my 20s. And I did the mailing for him of his catalogs. And I started out licking the envelopes, and I was like, absolutely no way. So I finally learned the trick of a decent sponge to run across the top of these large size envelopes. And I got fast after a while. And then after I got all of the envelopes sealed, I had to put them in alphabetical order and bring them to the post office. I have fond memories of that time in my life. That boyfriend was in a wheelchair. He was a C6 quadriplegic man. I don't like saying that in such a way that it titles him, because he was so much more than a quadriplegic. He was a beautiful man, very beautiful man. But for personal reasons, which I cannot tell you here, I was not able to follow through on our engagement to be married. But I worked for him and I did his care. And that time in our relationship gave me the experience that I needed to later in life get a job as a caregiver. So, I don't think that any of our experiences get wasted. Something good can come from the things that we go through, good or bad. Okay, I got a lot of letters to cover up here. Put some stickers on either end of this because it looks way too plain otherwise. Okay, that fits right there. That's good. Okay. prepared paper for that. I think I should be able to put it straight on this time. And I want to do it that way so that I get just outside of the white dividing line that is on this page. Sometimes it works that way and sometimes it doesn't. And I'm really not sure how I decided when I wanted to cover up the white lines or stay or leave them there. I tend to do some things in a hurry. It's like, hurry up and get ready for this project so I can sit down and relax. And that's the way I am about a lot of things. It's like, hurry, hurry, get this done so that I can enjoy doing this other thing in leisure. But anymore, I'm not in that much of a hurry about anything. Just some of the more unpleasant tasks I will get through a little bit more quickly. But in general, ASMR has caused me to slow down. The thing about these videos is, well, I've had some people say that they feel like watching my videos has taught them to slow down and sort of feel the things that they're doing and listen to the things that they're doing. And oddly, that is what started happening to me as well. I wasn't that way so much before I started taking and making these videos. So it's affected me in the same way. I need 2 stickers for this spot because I don't have any more large ones. So I'm going to put that one and then get another one for the edge. And I don't want to use the round one and make that same mistake like I did last time. So, let's... because I just don't want a single white letter to be showing or left. Very nice, very nice. Alright, just add that to the bottom and that will complete the look that I want. I'm going to remove a page and one full page of writing that is not necessary. Okay, so I am going to show you the process this time, whereas I did not last time. I think I spliced it out because of something that happened, a noise. I stopped the camera. I had to stop the camera. So many intrusions, can't even believe. Alright, so now that I've only got 2 pages of writing, and I could have just glued that page to the back, but I wanted there to be more. Space for writing things. Okay, get that. exit to the end of this video. Journal. Okay, just press that down. That's very nice, and it's going to make it even more crinkly when I go to use it. But this time, I'm also putting more glue on it and spreading it around a little bit more to make sure that the edges cannot fray. I don't want them to come up. I don't know how long I'll hold on to this journal, but it's one of those things that, you know, such good memories. And who knows, you know, maybe if I write some special and meaningful things in here, then after I die, the kids will hang on to it, maybe. And go, this is something neat that Mom made. Yeah. And then they'll have these videos too. Weird to think that these videos will still be on YouTube even if I died. Hey, what a morbid thought. Sorry about that. But it's kind of cool that my kids will have it as a legacy. Okay. Got to embellish this just a bit. Because it just looks too spacious and plain otherwise. Stick that on that little edge there. Didn't get it the first time. Yeah, that'll hold it down better. Do I want another one? Let me see here. May or may not call for another sticker. Let me think. Be good. Do I want one of these? I can't resist. Just put them in the corners. Nothing in the middle because I want to be able to write on there. Or maybe even, gosh, what if I could print out a photograph or something? Almost use it like a scrapbook as well. I've got all these ideas rattling around in my brain, but I'm not sure what I'm going to accomplish. We'll see. Okay, done here. Let me just show you this. I haven't finished it yet. But this is the final project. You see how much room I have now to write in all these different places, and yet keep the integrity of the photographs within. Right. And create. I am so gonna use this and hang on to it. So now, this is identified as a journal, no longer about the original thing, just pretty pictures. Okay, here's the one spot I didn't get to show you before. One big area to write in. Well, more than one, I'll show you. Let's add a couple stickers here real quick. Joy. I don't know why. I just feel like it needed a little bit more. Return to simpler times. That goes with what I believe. So. Oh, I'm just loving this. I'm just loving this. Can't wait to use it. Very bright. It could only have been a little bit better if my brown craft paper could have, a little less plain, I guess. Hearthside repast. Or if they had borders, if I could have put kind of border on each piece. Okay, so that's it. Thank you for joining me. Let me show you the final product.